The syramed PCA pump from Arcomed. It is safe, simple to use, and a smart pump. The drug library and configuration is developed in consultation with hospital representatives. The outside of the pump, at the back, it takes a standard power cord. This is the pole clamp and a carry handle. It can be put into a docking station or attached directly to an IV pole. On the front is the lockable arm and the PCA patient bolus button. The on and off key to turn the pump off, hold for 2 seconds. If you'd like to put the pump onto standby, just press briefly. This is the rate window, the data window, and the LCD screen, which is a touch color screen. Green and red for start and stop. And these are two hard keys, which have corresponding soft keys when you turn the pump on, one to escape and one to confirm. Now I'm going to load the syringe. Open the arm. Use your grip to pull the door forward. The pump automatically turns on. Open the clip. Place the syringe so that the flange is flat and sitting in the groove. Close the clip over the flange and close the door. Follow the prompts on the screen. Press and hold to load syringe until the syringe is engaged. Lock the arm. The pump is now asking me to confirm the type of syringe. Tick to confirm. The folders and icons are configured according to hospital requirements. Choose the folder that matches your prescription. I'm going to choose IV pain management, and then I'm going to choose adult IV PCA, continuous plus PCA, and morphine 1 milligram per mil. The pump is now asking me for a passcode, and it's flashing red here to tell me this is where I have to enter it. Each hospital has their own passcode. So I'm going to enter 1001 and tick to confirm. It's now asking me for the patient bolus. You can use the up and down arrows, but I'm going to keep it at 1 milligram and tick to confirm. The lockout, I'm going to keep, tick to confirm, and the continuous rate, tick to confirm. This is the home screen and it's in a holding pattern. You can see that morphine is color-coded blue for opioid. That is an ISO standard 26825, and this med marker is unique to Arcomed. Underneath the morphine, it is alternating between the drug concentration and the patient bolus and lockout. And the next line down is your background continuous dose per hour. And in the rate window, it's the background continuous rate per hour in mils. Once you are satisfied, start the pump. You know the pump is running because you have a green drop syringe here. There's tracking red lights under the windows and a green flashing syringe here. To give a patient bolus, the patient bolus button is ergonomically designed. The red light indicates it is properly connected and working. Press. One beep indicates that it's a successful bolus. Press again. Two beeps indicates it's being refused. So to access reports, some reports are on the home screen. You can see that 1 milligram has been infused. To access the PCA reports, press the green drop syringe and tells you how many patients successful boluses, how many refuse boluses. For more information, press I. This will give you a breakdown of an hourly summary of the PCA obs, as well as the amount infused in that hour in mils and in milligrams. To return to the home screen, press Escape. If you want to review your PCA parameters, press the PCA icon. If you want to change your PCA parameters, stop the pump, then press the PCA icon. It's asking for the passcode. Tick to confirm. And I'm going to change the patient bolus to 2 milligrams and tick to confirm. And the other parameters I'll keep the same, so I'll just confirm them. Back to the home screen and restart the pump. To give a clinician bolus as per the prescription, press the menu icon, find the bolus icon, enter the passcode as requested, tick to confirm, enter the dose for the bolus. I'm going to enter 0.5 of a milligram, and it's now asking me to deliver that using a hard key, not a soft key. Press, and that is now infusing. The syramed PCA has many alarms. I'm now going to demonstrate the open door alarm. Note that there's an audible and a visual alarm. To silence, press the bell. The visual alarm will continue until the problem is resolved. Then restart the pump. I'm now going to demonstrate changing a syringe. Stop the pump. Open the arm. Use the grip to open the door and the clip. Place the new syringe, close the clip and the door. Follow the prompts, press and hold to load syringe until it is engaged. Lock the door, lock the arm. And it's asking me to tick and confirm the type of syringe. If it is the same infusion as before, you can restart the pump. Now I'm going to show you what to do when the infusion is discontinued. Stop the pump. Remove the syringe. Press to park the syringe driver. And press and hold the off key for 2 seconds.